Hello and welcome to Your Property Empire. I'm Chris Gray. On tonight's show, what is it that makes one estate agent perform over another less successful one? As a buyer, what can you learn from real estate agents to enable you to get the first bite of the cherry and or at a cheaper price? And from a seller's perspective, are agents really worth the money and what value could they bring to you? Well, joining me tonight to give their opinions is Damian Steele from McGrath Estate Agents and Tom Panos, Head of Real Estate Advertising at News Corp. Good to see you, Damian and Tom.
Thanks for having me.
So let's start off. What's a sustainable agent?
It's a very good question. Look, I think for the most part, you need to have, putting skill set aside, you need to have longevity. You need to have a long-term approach. So I think if you're in it for the short game, you're going to come unstuck. So for the most part, though, if you don't love people, if you don't love long hours, if you don't love the smell of a deal, and if you have issues with rejection and setbacks, again, you're going to come unstuck. So I think sustainability means different things to different people, but for me, it's all those criterias.
Loving the time, Tom. How many of the agents loving the time in the job?
I think the issue is Damien's been spot on there talking about playing a long game. And Chris, that's what it's all about. And I think the best real estate agents, except if they want to succeed, they've got to fail faster. And you're going to fail so many times because you're going to have so many people that are going to say to you they're buying this house and they don't, or that they're going to give you their house to sell and they don't. And you go home and that week, that month, you've made no money. Which is a hard thing, to be worked 40, 50, 60 hours a week and not be making any money.
And Damien, you're one of the most successful and most well-known agents in the eastern suburbs, which is probably one of the most competitive markets in Australia. So I guess for the other agents out there, why would you want to get into real estate and what's kept you in it for so long?
Look, again, it probably ties in with the first question. Why do you want to get into real estate? I think if you genuinely love helping people, that's going to go a long way. And I think if you like flexibility as well, that's also going to go a long way. And having no ceiling on what you can achieve and what you can actually earn, that's going to go a long way as well. So I think you need a certain personality type. I think you can have to have tough skin to an extent. You have to be able to negotiate. You have to be able to connect with all walks of life. So they're probably the key things, Chris.
Now, Tom, you obviously train a lot of the real estate agents as well as kind of do your auctioneering and all your other half a dozen jobs and the rest of it.
Yeah.
Can all of this stuff be trained, or is there a certain type that just is a perfect agent?
I think people can get better at it. I think some people have got an innate ability to be able to read the play. But if you've actually got someone that works very long hours and speaks to more people, they can actually equalize that disadvantage. And as time goes by, they're going to get the experience of being able to understand what someone's really saying versus what they're just saying verbally. So the answer is that, yes, there is a disposition that you'll be better versus another person, but you'll get better anyway through training and development.
And I guess that's the classic thing with sales, is people say, I'm trying to do quality and the rest of it, but if someone just gets some quantity out there and they do it reasonably well, that's got to work out if they're doing 10 times the calls.
Absolutely, and the word gets out, Chris. When you're doing good stuff, you know, and Damien will know that when he's out there doing good work, one neighbour says it to another neighbour. That becomes the work in real estate afterwards.
And I guess if you had your time again, is there anything you change if you're kind of, starting all over again?
Yeah, look, I think there's a few things. I think try and manage the fact that you're overwhelmed and wanting to absorb everything. I think the key thing is to connect yourself in shadow with someone that you admire, that is doing things that you want to be doing in 5-10 years. I think that's key. And I think just keep it simple, really. Just find out what your strengths are. Work out what the gaps and your weaknesses are as well. But, you know, perhaps don't dwell on those too much. But work on your strengths and hone in on them and keep things concentrated. But above and beyond, just go nuts. Over-surface people and make them love you and make them talk about you, as Tom said before.
And so where does the most of your business come from?
For the most part, it's past clients and referrals. And again, Tom touched on it. If you do the right thing by people, they're going to tell the world. They're going to actually go out of their way and tell the world. So for me, past clients and referrals, I'm not the agent that gets a lot of business out of stuffing people's letterboxes with my face and my name. So really, it's people that have touch points. Yeah, I know. I don't get it either. But it's really, you have to have a touch point, I think, a couple of touch points to be able to actually deserve the business.
And Tom, I guess, is there daily routines that agents need to go through?
Yeah, and it can get boring. It's a bit like swimming laps in the pool. and that is that you're doing over and over again. And I've got to say that, you know, after a while, if you're looking at agents, Damian would probably walk into 50, 100, 200 houses a year. After a while, kitchens begin to look all pretty much the same, and it's being able to have this ability to rock up at each appointment with a buyer and seller and look at them as if you're talking to them for the first time in your life. So it's being able to handle that.
Now, Damian, you are in one of the most competitive markets, so how do you differentiate yourself from all the other agents? And even in your office, that McGrath's probably got some of the best agents in the suburbs, so assume in your office then there's competition in there as well.
Look, there is, and it's a really good question, and I think there's an awful lot of things that agents do the same. You know, to a lot of owners and prospective clients, we are two black dots. So how are you going to add value? I think the key thing first is find out what their values are. Now, that may sound a little bit cliched, but if you can actually tap into what's important to that particular client, what's driving them, what's scaring them, what's motivating them, because it's really not about the property as such. It's about actually how to get them moving and how to do it in a fashion that they're comfortable with. So in answer to your question, I think it's listening. I think it's adding value and demonstrating that value, because if you can't demonstrate it, then they might as well stand out the front of their house with a hat and have people drop offers in. Within McGrath, I think for the most part, there's an element of healthy competition, but we do absolutely practice teamwork. And that's definitely one of our points of differences as well, that when we sit in someone's lounge room, we can say, you're not just getting Damian Steele, you're getting a whole harem of other agents who will want to do the right thing by you.
And Tom, just as a final thing before we move on, I guess what difference does it, from the seller's perspective, what difference can it make from having an average agent to an exceptional agent?
In a nutshell, 5 to 10%, probably. I think if a great agent uses good marketing, has got good negotiation skills, knows how to read the play with buyers, finds the best buyer, not the first buyer, and does all of that, I think it can be worth between 5 and 10%. So when you look at what an agent gets paid, you know, approximately 2% thereabouts, you're looking at a decent return of investment if they get you that 5 to 10% premium. But if they don't.
And again, as I've heard you said many times in your courses, is any agent can sell a property, but it's selling it for that 5 or 10%. That's what you're paying them for.
Well, Sydney, Melbourne, we see the clearance rates by Charles Tarby here every weekend. High clearance rate, Sydney, Melbourne. It's not about getting it sold. It's about house price maximisation. It's about getting top dollar, because in great marketplaces, in great suburbs, properties sell themselves.
So, sounds good. Well, let's jump to properties of the week, and we'll jump into the first one.
Yeah, well, they're both in hot